Hello, my name is Dr. Artour Rakhimov, and today I'm sitting with a yoga teacher and also Buteyko breathing practitioner now, Volker Schmitz from Hamburg, Germany. And my question to Volker is, he's my good friend for years, and my question would be about, since he's yoga teacher, how breathing retraining, how changes in our automatic or unconscious breathing pattern, like the way we breathe, is going to help people who practice yoga, let's say for 2, 3, 5, 10 years. So what would be the benefits if these people manage to change, because it's also not so easy, not so simple to make changes in our unconscious or automatic breathing?
Yes. So first of all, we have to say here that when we talk about yoga now, we don't mean only postures or only pranayama, which are the breathing exercises from yoga, but yoga more in general, which also, of course, includes meditation or, let's say, psychological states of mind. Mm-hmm. So, and in this manner, breathing will have an impact on all of these areas. And for example, the area when it comes to postures, endurance, or when it comes to psychological disposition, like more concentration and more abilities in terms of reaching objects, which you have, first of all, you have an object in your mind, and then later you reach it through meditation, which is one of the goals of yoga, which one can argue this is real yoga. And then also, of course, pranayama, the exercises will be changed a lot if you are able to change your unconscious breathing, which is the goal of the Buteyko technique.
What is the problem with current breathing in people? Like if you think about your typical students, when they arrive, what is wrong with their breath?
Yeah, as you know, most people would, for example, train pranayama, but do not train their unconscious breathing patterns.
And what is wrong with it?
There will be no change then.
What is wrong with the unconscious automatic breathing in ordinary people?
Yeah, most of the ordinary people, if you may can explain it to them, are breathing too much during sleep and during the rest of the day. Maybe they breathe right during pranayama exercises, but not the rest of the day. So
exactly, yeah. If we think about medical studies, and there are,
maybe you can explain this famous table of health.
Yeah, take a table of health zone. So if we measure breathing in ordinary people, in average, according to dozens of studies which measure minute ventilation, which measure CO2, how much is breathing frequency, breathing rate, other parameters, we found that people breathe about twice more than the normal in terms of minute ventilation. That means they have mild form of hyperventilation, hidden hyperventilation. That means people kind of don't feel it, don't notice much, but we already hyperventilate. And the results for the body oxygen test for them would be around 20 seconds, quite low number. They can hold breath after exhale without stress only for this amount of time, whereas 100 years ago it was common 40, 50 seconds to have.
Exactly. And this is a very important factor, because at times yoga was developed. Most of the people, the beginners in yoga, had those kinds of breathing, which today the normal student does not have. This is our problem as a yoga teacher, that even yoga students and even teachers are often on this level of breathing.
About 20 seconds, which is makes we have mild form of hyperventilation day and night, 24 hours per day. Now, when the students manage to improve their breath, let's say we achieve 50, 60 seconds for the body oxygen test, which in my experience would be my best students, but you had also such students as well.
Of course.
What would be the changes which we experience?
Yeah, as I mentioned, there were physical changes and psychological.
Such as?
For example, one side effect would be that people lose weight, so that they get to the ideal weight, for example, or such high values of in terms of morning CP would also lead to less sleep and much more endurance. And for example, somebody may start exercising 1-2 hours every day of yoga asana practice, which can be very hard for a person with 20 seconds CP or even 25 to 30, but it would be much easier for a person with 40 and 50 CP. This kind of person would almost love all exercises and all yoga practice. So it's much easier for such a person to to exercise. And of course, the quality of the exercises will also be enhanced because of much more concentration, better blood flow, and better control of the nervous system, muscular functions, and so on. So the benefits are, there are many, many benefits of better breathing. That's the reason why pranayama was also kind of center of all the yoga practice. Although it's not its final goal, which is maybe more to find a meditation area, but the center and the main tool was always breathing, and this seems to be correct.
Mm-hmm. And finally, if people achieve, like some yoga books I read long time ago, that they claim that yoga masters, like real yoga masters, who were like, these days hard to say how many of them, but 100 years ago and before, they could achieve a breathing pattern when we have only, like, let's say, 3 breaths a minute in the state of super health.
Yeah.
And I was really surprised finding that some yoga books written long time ago, not last 50 years, but 70 years ago, 100 years ago, that we also mentioned that yoga masters start to sleep naturally only about 2 hours.
Yeah.
For me, it was really interesting coincidence because Dr. Buteyko, who developed this table,
yeah,
and some of his colleagues also, we achieved this state when they have up to 2.5-3 minutes for the breath holding time for the
exactly.
CP test.
Yeah.
And we also had 2 hours of sleep.
Yeah.
But not all these doctors practice yoga pranayama. We used a different approach. But the final result,
but they did breathing exercises,
totally the same as for yoga.
So we could call it, because pranayama just only means control of the breathing. So the Buteyko method, prana is the breath, and yama is also like control over the breath. So it's almost, we could argue that the Buteyko method in itself is pranayama. Like, so,
okay. Yep.
Of course, with my students, it's the same. When they get to, let's say, 40 CP in the morning, they most of the time don't sleep more than 6 hours, mostly 5 or 5.5. Mm-hmm. And when they come to 60 CP in the morning, they sleep 4 hours or 4.5.
And level
and
of energy,
even less
exercise.
The level of energy is
craving
is
exercise.
Really can be really extreme. For example, when you're above, let's say, 60 to 90 CP, the ability to meditate is extremely enhanced. It's totally easy then to meditate, for example, and you can get very deep fastly, which is maybe almost impossible on lower CPs, like this kind of deepness, for example. So there are many benefits, of course.